Welcome to Entrepreneurs International Network, where entrepreneurs learn, network, and grow. I'm Roger Killen, the organizer. Today, Captain Lou Edwards is training us on how to access massive audiences by using other people's lists. Captain Lou, I've got three questions that will help us get to know you. Number one, these are skill testing questions. Number one, what is your greatest accomplishment?
Oh, each, I would say my greatest accomplishment is going from an orphaned eighth grade dropout who's never seen the inside of a high school to go on and lecture at colleges, write three books, be a blessing in people's lives and help people build their businesses. But besides that, it's my 30-year love of my life who's off camera right now, Phyllis, she says, keep it that way. She's not camera ready. My greatest accomplishment has got to be maintaining a loving relationship with my better half, Phyllis, for 30 years and hopefully another 30 to come. Right, honey?
I hope she nodded her head up and down and not side to side. Yes. Second question is this. Captain Lou, what is your favorite way to have fun?
I'll give you three guesses, Roger.
And the third guess is?
cruising with like-minded souls sharing similar goals. That's my favorite way to have fun. Let me admit new people in.
Beautiful. And the third question, what is the best piece of advice anyone has ever given you? The best piece of advice anyone has ever given you?
Well, it's a tie between keep your life and your business at a manageable level. For entrepreneurs, that's often difficult to do. And that's tied with customer service. You know, I just blanked out. I'm sorry, I had a senior moment. But customer service is the number one priority on the island of relevancy. That's it, that's my line. Apologies, folks. I learned both things from a dear lifelong friend, Kevin, a plumber from Indiana, who's never created a business card and has had more business that he can handle just by, he can scribble his name and phone number on a napkin in crayon and have an overwhelming amount, an overflowing amount of business just by those principles of keeping things at a manageable level, making others feel comfortable, and also customer service. Unbelievable customer service, which seems to be dying in our modern technological age, where all you get are phone trees when you call. You can't ever get a human being. So anyway, that's it. Those are my answers.
Okay, lovely. Participants, during Captain Lou's training, please type your questions into the chat. I'll pose them in batches to Captain Lou during his talk. Now, you're going to be sent a link to the recording of this training in a few hours, but I nevertheless encourage you to take notes, because the very act of taking notes will increase what you absorb by as much as 30%. Captain Lou, are you ready to knock our socks off?
Well, that depends. Roger and everybody else that's here, good morning, thank you for being here. Can you help me? Can you help me overcome my shyness? What do you think?
I think we can.
Okay. So, you know, with this face made for radio, let's forge ahead. And the title of my presentation, Roger, is The Accidental Joint Venture Millionaire, which is what I became, and I'll tell you my story. I'm still admitting people. So am I still doing this, or are you? I think you'll take over that. You'll take over the admissions, right?
Correct.
So we're going to talk about accessing massive audiences with OPL, other people's lists. And Roger, I want you to stay with me, and I want you to interrupt, step on my toes if you need to, and of course, update me with questions as from our wonderful participants. So I'm Captain Lou from marketerscruise.com. I own a company called Special Events at Sea, where we produce life-changing, business-building events on cruise ships that are kind of like seminars, but they're not really. They're unseminars. And I'll talk a little bit about that and how I got started and how my life changed on a dime in 2003. And I went from mediocrity. I went from zero to hero, from Captain Who to Captain Lou, and how you might be able to do the same thing. But some of you already with us are superstars in your own niche, or future superstars in online business. I'm really glad you're all here with me. This is a presentation of if I can do it, if I can achieve success, anybody can. And have fun at the same time while we're doing that. So let's begin. So first of all, who is the real Captain Lou? How many of you here, you can type in the chat box, recognize this guy. That'll really show your age. This is Captain Lou Albano, manager of champions. I had the privilege of working with Captain Lou from 1978 to 1982, back right before Hulk Hogan and Vince McMahon revolutionized pro wrestling as the sports entertainment business it is today, billion-dollar business it is today. But back then, you know what happened? I think I alluded at the beginning, maybe in the preamble before we went live, that I was orphaned as a teenager. Pretty much close to homeless. I dropped out of eighth grade, never seen the inside of a high school. I ran away. I ran off to join the circus. So for me, the circus was pro wrestling and Vince McMahon's World Wrestling Federation. I wasn't looking for a handout. I was looking for a hand up, and they took me in. And in short order, I became ring announcer, color commentator, radio talk show host, backstage interviewer, timekeeper at the bell, all of those things, while on tour with people like Andre the Giant, Bruno Sammartino, Classy Freddie Blassie, the Polish power Ivan Putski, and my dear friend, departed now, Mr. Captain Lou Albano. These guys taught me showmanship. How many of you are familiar with pro wrestling? I'm looking at the comments. I'm looking at the comments, right? Albano wasn't girls, just want to have fun with Cindy Lauper. Somebody, Kevin says, Karun says, I loved Andre the Giant. So these were my friends back in the late 70s, early 80s. And after 4 years of being the voice of Monday Night Wrestling for Vince McMahon, and I sounded like this, I sounded like one of our, like Mike sounds, right? Mike is the one with the deep voice with us today. So I sounded like this all the time. I walked around sounding like a cross between Don Pardo and Ted Baxter from the Mary Tyler Moore Show. Who remembers the Mary Tyler Moore Show? Oh my goodness. So at the end of 4 years, my well-meaning friends and what was left of distant relatives and family said to me, Lou, pro wrestling will never be big. The champions don't even make $100,000. It's on the late night UHF stations. Nobody really cares about wrestling. It's got a cult audience. You've got to stop following the wrestlers around and get a real job and a career. And because this is not a, wrestling is not a business you're going to be in. You've got to go get a real job. So what did I do? I listened to all my well-meaning friends, and I got out of pro wrestling, where I was a personality. And right before Vince McMahon teamed with Hulk Hogan to kind of take wrestling to the level that you all know it now, which is, you know, billion-dollar enterprise. So timing is everything. I had none of it. And the moral of this story is, well, never take advice from people whose lives you wouldn't want. So I exited wrestling. And my next crazy career change from 1980 to 2000 is I was, I knew I had to nicheify. I knew I had to focus on one thing, and that one thing was window treatments. In fact, window blinds. So I was a window decorator. And I remember people calling me the blind man. So in window treatment sales, it was lucrative. I did this for about 20 years. In fact, I remember I had this, by the way, Roger, how do you make a Venetian blind?
How do you make a Venetian blind? I haven't the slightest idea.
Anybody want to take a guess? Type it in the chat box. Poke them in the eyes. And if you don't buy verticals from us, it's going to be curtains for you. I need another groan there in the chat box.
Double groan.
So, okay. So basically, that was my thing, the blinds. And we had the phone number 888 blind man and all of that shtick. And I tried to get vanity plates from the New York City Department of Motor Vehicles that said blind man, you know, to go with the whole blind man thing. And guess what? They rejected my application saying it would be offensive to blind people, blind man plates. So I called up the DMV. I said, how would they know, right? But they didn't approve it. They did approve these, which now 40 years later, that I still drive around in my Sebring convertible. Yes, I am having a midlife Chrysler with these plates that say lunatic. Can you guys tell that I'm a frustrated would-be comedian? That is a legal plate. Yes. Pat's asking, is it a legal plate? Yes. And I, if I accidentally speed, go too fast, go to a red light, I guess stop. It's just like, what's wrong with you? And I guess they say, what's wrong with you? They just check my plates. I'm a lunatic. So, okay, all right, we'll let you go. This is a legal New York license plate I've had for the last 30 years. And like Billy Joel says, it just may be a lunatic you're looking for. Because, you know, after 20 years of making a living with the blind, I decided I'd like to start making a life. I don't want to do this forever. And I wanted to get into travel. I wanted to teach. How can I be a teacher if I'm an eighth grade dropout? I've always wanted to teach. I want to help people in business. And I like cruises, so maybe I'll start a little business in the cruise industry. But no one, even back then, thought that going into travel was a good idea, because why would you go from a business where you're making 30, 40% margin to a travel agency business where you're grossing 10% and that's gross before expenses? It makes no sense, you know. But as God is my witness, I am that lunatic, and that's exactly what I did. So the importance of writing down your goals. For me, it was to help fulfill dreams and fantasies. If I could do that for others beyond covering their windows, then in fact, I would be fulfilling my own dreams and fantasies. I hope that each and every one of you watching really understand and feel that what you get is equal to what you give, even if it doesn't seem that way at the moment. Now, some people have lofty goals. They want to find a cure for cancer, end world hunger. For me, it was to earn enough money online so that when I lose the rest of my hair, Phyllis will still find me attractive, which she does anyway, because she knew me before the money came. It's very, very important, by the way, to have people in your life that love you before you become rich. Internet lifestyle 1.0 was, I remember, you stay at home, hiding behind your computer. You submit JV proposals to strangers by email. And this is for online entrepreneurs. And if you don't know what JV stands for, we'll get to that in a moment. And long before there were funnels and online courses and these Zoom workshops, you'd work for months building a website and wait patiently for the world to be the path to your door. And this is when, you know, we all started out online, right? And we were feeling, sowing our oats, feeling things out. This got a little frustrating. How many of you remember, that's me, by the way, how many of you remember that computer, the CRT? Right, Roger? I was talking with Roger about, you remember the DOS and the green screen and the orange, right? I know Mike remembers all of that because he's a software programmer developer. And so, by the way, quickie quiz for everyone. What was the first, back in those days, what was the first video game? Roger, do you remember the first video game? And anybody else? That's right, okay. Mark says Pong. Pong is the right answer, that's right. And we have come a long way. We remember Pac-Man and Asteroids, but it started out with Pong. And it was frustrating. We didn't have any idea about what the internet did or could do, but we knew it was very, very exciting, right? So here's what I learned about marketing by following Woody Allen's advice. Does anyone remember what Woody Allen said about success? If you do, type it into the chat box before I have a chance to say it. What did Woody Allen say about success? He said 80% of success is just showing up. Who said that? Joe, got it? And Roger, that's right. Okay, so 80% of success is just showing up. And that's what I did January 30th of 2003, trying to break out of the blinds business and create something new in the world of travel where I could maybe attract clients, not just from around the corner or in my community, but across the country, and I didn't even think maybe around the world. And so I show up at something called the Big Seminar on Internet Marketing in Dallas, Texas, January 30th of 2003. I'll never forget that weekend as I'm learning from people that are the pioneers at the time of online marketing. This is before we had Zoom and meetups and webinars and Google, and this is before Amazon and YouTube, and this is before we were doing teleseminars because there was no video webinars. This is 2003. That, can you believe that was only 18 years ago? And I'm there, and I'm like a deer in the headlights, and I have absolutely no idea how my life is about to change. So you guys want to hear how I became the accidental joint venture millionaire without a plan, without a product, without a list, or even a clue, by just showing up to an event like this, only it was live in Dallas, and creating this persona of Captain Lou. So who wants to hear this, or should I just go back to sleep? What do you think? Do I look like Captain Steubing from the Love Boat in this picture? I don't know. Somebody did this for me, so I threw it into the slide. You know, he passed away, the actor that played Steubing, just recently. But I used to love watching the Love Boat, which is shot on a Princess cruise ship, I believe. And I thought, this might be an interesting, look, pro wrestling, window blinds, cruises. So I go to this event to learn how to start my cruise business online. And my well-meaning friends and family at the time, and remember, I had very little family left, said, Lou, the internet is a scam or it's a fad. And at best, no one in their right mind is going to put in $1,000, $2,000, $3,000, $5,000 online to purchase a trip. So you're off on a wild goose chase. You're wasting your time and money. Stick with the bread and butter of the blinds business. Now, I'm a Depression-era child of my dad was 62 when he had me. My dad was born in 1897. He taught me that just, you know, keep your nose clean, work hard. Don't look for fulfillment and lofty goals. Just, if you have a good job, make a living, put some away for a rainy day, and that's it. And so he didn't encourage ambitions like we're all doing now. And now my friends are saying, This is a scam. This is a fad. You're not going to be able to start some kind of an internet business. Now remember, 20 years earlier in pro wrestling, I listened to my friends and I got out before Hulk Hogan got in. Roger, did I listen to my friends this time when they said, don't go to Texas?
I hope not.
Right. I said, you know what? If not me, who? If not now, when? Let's go do this and let's find out what can be accomplished. So I show up at this event and there are speakers and they have software and they have products and they have training. And I just want to learn how to put up a web page about travel. I have no idea what my travel business is going to look like. I really am green. I'm a deer in the headlights. And all of a sudden, there's this woman in the audience who on the break whispers to me, hey, Captain Lou, want to do a JV? Want to do a JV? Now, I'd never heard the term JV before. And I said, what? What is that? What are you talking about? She says, a joint venture. You want to do a joint venture. Now, it was noisy in the room and I didn't hear right. I thought she was asking me to do a joint in the bathroom, to smoke a joint with her. I really thought that. I'd never heard the term joint venture or JV. That's how green I was. So she says, come to lunch with me and I'll tell you my idea. And at lunch, she says to me, as a marketer, I wish that there were a tropical island where I could just hang out in a relaxed atmosphere, not as a guru or a student, but in a mastermind group of my peers, like-minded souls who share similar goals, helping to build each other's businesses through friendships first, a place where everyone knows where I'm coming. I remember this was even before meetups became big. And Roger, I said, what are you getting at? She says, this type of seminar, this conference, instead of a stuffy hotel conference room, could you help us produce an event like this on a cruise ship? And we have each of the speakers and the host email their list. Now I didn't have a list. And isn't there something where if you sell a certain amount of cabins, then you get a free cabin? And if they all email their lists, then maybe they can go for free. And then we have an event on a cruise ship. Is that something that you could help me do? Now, having never done anything more than friends and family on a cruise ship, maybe once or twice, having no experience whatsoever in producing seminars and special events at sea with audio and video and speakers and private parties and dinners and excursions and meeting space, no experience whatsoever. I turned to her and I said, oh, sure, I think I can help you with that. Then I leaned in a little bit closer and said, Holly, in fact, that's my specialty. Now, how many of you would have taken that risk, that gamble, that jump? Because really at this point, I had no experience in the cruise industry whatsoever. And leaned into the opportunity, not fake it until you make it, but actually act and live as if you are that future success story. And say, I'm gonna do this. I could have been really big in pro wrestling as one of those colorful wrestling managers or characters. And I got out of that. Blinds, okay, we would measure people's windows and install some nice blinds. That's not something I wanted to do for 50 years. Can I do this? And the answer is yes. In that moment, leaning in and saying yes to the opportunity, my life changed on a dime. My business completely changed. And the first event I did on Halloween weekend in 2003. It was called an affiliate marketers cruise. Boy, I was green. I didn't know what I was doing. In fact, I think I did everything wrong. It looked nothing like the massive million-dollar events I put on today all over the world. It was just me flying by the seat of my pants. At one point, I felt so self-conscious, friends. I thought that everyone hated the event and hated me. I thought that they can see, they would see that I'm a fraud. I'm not the expert I claim to be. I don't have the experience or the skill set. I've taken their money under false pretenses. And I felt that I did a terrible job. You know, the enemy is in the mirror. It's your own reflection. You look in the mirror and you tell yourself these terrible things. I ran back to my cabin. We had a couple of issues. And I wanted to just hide under the bed and break into tears because I thought that I did an awful job. Remember, you see all the flaws. You see all the flaws in everything that you do in your business, in your job. You are your biggest critic. A couple of hours later, I come out of the cabin and people are coming up to me to hug me, high five me. This was many, many years before COVID. I don't think they're doing that this year. But they were like, Captain Lou, this was the most amazing thing ever. I teamed up with a couple of people. We're doing a product launch. I'm starting a business because of this cruise. I'm growing a business. They came to me and they said, and we've had so much fun. When are we doing it again? This is brilliant. We love it. We love you. And I'm like, what? And you ever see somebody talking to you and you look over your shoulder because you figure they're talking to someone else, but they really are talking to you. And now they're giving you these acknowledgments and accolades, but you still don't feel like you deserve it. So you're kind of shy and making excuses and saying, you don't know what to say. But then I knew I was on to something. And you know what? Ready, fire, aim. Right, take action, revise later. Finished is better than perfect. So this wasn't perfect, but I had something finished that people liked enough to say, where can we sign up for the next one? So this was very, very enlightening for me. And now, of course, you guys know at this point, 18 years later, there is a place where you can relax, network, joint venture, and brainstorm for 8 days straight on sun-drenched Caribbean islands with people like Mike Fulsame, my $100 million software developing partner, Groove Funnels and Groove Digital, Tom Beal, Roger Killen, Iman Agay, Bill Walsh, Jay Fassett, James Dentley, Davin Michaels, Paul Fick. These names that I'm putting up on the slide, if you don't know them, you need to get to know them because these are some of the brightest marketing minds on the planet, 6, 7, and 8-figure earners from around the world that have really made their mark online, and hundreds of others. So imagine spending a week just networking and schmoozing while Caribbean cruising, where profitable deals are done while on vacation and having fun. There's a picture of me with some of our group and on Grand Turk Island, and cruise ship in the background. And we're now in our 15th year running. And we have probably helped create probably between $500 million and $1 billion in new business partnerships, joint ventures, product launches, membership sites, continuity programs, software rollouts, niche businesses, and friendships between people that would never have been able to connect if it wasn't for this cruise. So it's not a teaching cruise, it's a networking and masterminding cruise where everyone is on stage. Everyone has, there's a level playing field and everyone can contribute something to be a blessing in each other's lives. And it took about 15 years to kind of figure out the format and flow for this to get the most out of it for everyone. So that's not guru student. It's not experts pontificating from the pulpit. It's everyone who's got an online business participate. So before I'm gonna ask everyone's permission Roger wanted me to invite all of you to come and join us in whatever remaining cabins that might be available for this upcoming cruise in November. But before I do that, I do want to show you that I practice what I preach. So right now I'm leveraging OPL, other people's lists. That person is Roger Killen. Roger approached me. Now, Roger's coming on the cruise. He's heard for years that's where the cool cats are. And he wants to be part of that scene. And he said, hey, can you do a presentation for my network, for my audience, for my tribe? Because I feel that they would deserve to have an invitation opportunity like this. This is by invitation only, this event. We don't put billboards up over highways. It's by invitation only. So you're being invited by Roger. And I'm leveraging Roger's list right now in his organization. And he asked me to do that. My entire business has been based upon people seeing that I've got something fun and cool and profitable and asking to partner with me. And that's what you all have to think about for your own businesses. I've never solicited anyone to come on any of my cruise events. And I do murder mysteries and martial arts and real estate and finance and keto diet and marketing, of course. My favorite is this marketing cruise because it's entrepreneurs. But I've never solicited and I've always been approached to be part of this, like back in 2003, the story I told you. And of course, if you come from a place of integrity and honesty and care, people will want to help you grow your business once they see, you know, what you're all about. So,
Lou, a couple of questions.
Sure.
I'm quite sure several of the people on the call have zero experience with joint venture partnerships. Could you explain how all that works? And the second question is from Mark. And what if we have $0 to spare, invest, and spend? How do we get into anything like this?
Okay. Well, I'll start with the second question from Mark, is that you obviously need some operating capital for your business. To get into the marketer's cruise, it's just the cost of a cruise. We don't mark it up, and I'll go into that in a little while. I started my entire business back in 2003 with less than a couple of grand. I flew to Texas. I met the right people. I put this together. It didn't require a $10,000, a $50,000, or a $100,000 investment. It just required me putting together, in this case, a service, because my product is a service, and finding people that already had lists of people that they'd like to expose me to. That's the whole topic of this presentation, is how to utilize and leverage other people's lists to get to a countrywide or worldwide audience that want what you have to offer. Now, you need to have a business. That business needs to be online. And I will be very honest and transparent here, Roger. I'm not teaching people how to start an online business. I'm taking you, if you have even the beginning of an online business, whether it be products, services, trainings, and I'm putting you together, like Roger is doing right here this morning, with other people of like mindset. And when you spend a week or 8 days with those people breaking bread and going to the beach and going sailing and things like that, things happen more organically in terms of fleshing out a business. How do you do a joint venture? Very simple. It's got to be a win-win for both parties. I'll give you an example of this joint venture with Roger. When Roger gets 10 from his tribe to come on as his guest to the marketer's cruise, not only will it, I mean, really provide an amazing springboard for success for your online business, but when Roger gets 10 cabins, we have actually the world's worst affiliate program, but Roger still said, yes, I want to be part of this. And the affiliate program is after you refer 10 people, you get $2,000. as an award, but more important than the $2,000, you get 30 minutes of stage time in front of 400 to 500 world-class marketers and entrepreneurs to present on a topic of your expertise. Now, Roger separately teaches on how to have a signature speech and how to do a TEDx-style talk that's in your back pocket so you can go anywhere in the world and speak. And really, that's what you want more than, that's what you want to build your business more than the $2,000 reward for amassing some people coming on a cruise. You want the exposure, the acknowledgement, and the recognition so that people come up to you and say, how can I help you? How can I partner with you? Maybe you can speak on my stage. Is that right, Roger?
That's correct, yes.
Right. So basically, somebody just typed in, I have an online grocery business with how much inventory?
With millions of dollars of organic inventory on consignment. How do I JV or get other people?
Okay, so that's a great question. So we have, so for an online grocery business, what you're looking to do is learn how to market better so you have a higher conversion rate, how to build your list better so that your current client list grows, how to get more referrals. And then the double-edged sword of this is that when you meet people in the same niche on a place like the Marketers Cruise that have the same synergy, they might want to promote you. And it's up to you to brainstorm and mastermind a mutual win-win that's profitable for both and for your clients. So it's A, gaining marketing chops and knowledge on list building and on conversion for more sales, and B, finding a strategic partner in the same niche that can collaborate with you to take your business further, perhaps to their audiences, if it's a fit. So see, there's two things here, learning and partnering in your business particular. That's a fantastic, fantastic niche business. Just like I had the blinds business. We had specialized blinds. Why would I come on the Marketers Cruise to learn how to market my window? Now I'm not in the window treatment business anymore. So learn how to get more leads and convert to more sales and basically build better marketing funnels and so forth. How to be the expert in my niche, how to write my book, how to write your first book in the online grocery field. There'll be tons of people that will show you how to get, I've written 3 books in travel and in marketing that has gotten me invitations to stages around the world. How do you do that? The business that you already have. And if you're already in a 7-figure business, how do you take it? How do you add a 0 to that? How do you make it an 8-figure business? And these are some of the things that you can do. And this goes for everyone that's watching right now. You want to say, how can I improve my marketing with leads and conversion to sale? And who can I meet that's in the same niche as me that maybe has the list that I don't and love my product? So these are 2 very important takeaways. Let me go on to the next slide here. I have to tell you, okay, so this is the invitation to the cruise. Welcome to invitation to Lifestyle 3.0. We talked about 1.0 and 2.0. So these days, if you have a laptop, and perhaps even if it's a smartphone, and an idea with legs, then life can be a vacation as you celebrate your success from the beaches of the world. That's when my friend Kevin said, you need to keep your life and business at a manageable level. So, okay, we've got to figure that out. Cruise events on helping businesses build, helping build each other's business. So November 6th to the 14th, we'll be sailing on the 15th annual Marketers Entrepreneurial Cruise round trip from Port Canaveral, Orlando to Aruba, Bonaire, and Grand Turk Island, where we will be collaborating in the Caribbean. And again, peer-to-peer, not cruise students. Everyone here in this meetup group has a lifetime of experience in one way or another that they can contribute. And all of you are entrepreneurs. And if you're not already online with your own business, you're the future success story. Like I was when I showed up like a deer in the headlights in 2003. Really, I had no idea that this would happen. And I was almost going to say, and it was so easy, but no, it's taken me 18 years to become an overnight success. So it wasn't snap a finger and overnight millions. So we will be celebrating Living the Laptop Lifestyle 3.0. We start out in Cocoa Beach, Florida, with our big networking party pre-cruise, right on the beach at the Tiki Bar. Oh, that looks pretty. I want to be there now. Look at that. Does anybody know where this is? Type in the chat box. Where is this? This is, I think, our first stop on the cruise. And does anyone recognize it? I will just tell you, that is Aruba. So we're headed to Aruba. That is also Aruba. Very, very colorful, beautiful, beautiful. Anybody here ever been to Aruba in the ABC Islands? Does anybody know what the B and the C stand for? Type it into the chat box so we can make this more of a dialogue than a monologue. Pink flamingos. Could this also be Aruba? Oh, yes, it is. It is, it is. Very nice. Now this is Bonaire. Bonaire is the B in the ABC Islands, and Bonaire is really known for its scuba diving, snorkeling, great coral reefs. It's an unspoiled island, another Dutch island that's really beautiful. Has anybody here been to Aruba or Bonaire? If not, would you like to? This is absolutely gorgeous. And then we have our amazing networking beach and pool party at Grand Turk Island in the Turks and Caicos. I have to tell you folks, I've been on about 63 cruises now. We've done many groups around the world, and I've been very blessed to see places that are on many people's bucket lists and see it with people that are just wonderful, wonderful people. So this is Grand Turk Island. They have a Margaritaville and a Flow Rider and a giant saltwater, freshwater pool with swim up bar and massages on the beach. Oh my goodness, just absolutely heavenly, heavenly. And then 3 luxurious days at sea where we do the business building masterminds, the networking parties, and something special from Roger. Because when you join with Roger, we have to make a little something, right, Roger? Don't we have to do a little something special for your people?
Absolutely, but now I'm a little terrified because I've no clue what the something special is.
Oh, it's a surprise.
Oh, it's a surprise to me too, is it? Okay.
You know what? We've got 4 months to figure it out. So we will deliver something special to your people. Is that a deal?
That's a deal.
Awesome. I love it. I love it. You love the curveballs, Roger?
Yes, indeed.
Do you like roller coasters? They're building a cruise ship with a roller coaster. But we're not going on that one. We're going. Hendrick says, I look at Aruba as a future golden visa investment. So VIP could mean vacation in paradise, right? But it also means a vacation integrated with profit. Now, not everyone's thinking, now what is this cruise with marketers and entrepreneurs? What is this atmosphere that Captain Lou has created? Please take 4 minutes to watch this, and I think it'll explain a lot more from our actual members of the Marketers Crew.
Hey, this is Captain Lou, producer planner of the amazing annual mastermind vacation known as the Marketers Cruise. Here we are with 445 of our best marketing buddies from 18 countries around the world.
This is my fourth. This is my third.
Second.
First. Ninth annual
Marketers Cruise.
It really wasn't a hard sell. Go on a cruise for a week and network with some of the top marketing professionals in the industry.
It's a vacation combined with a seminar.
These are just real extraordinary experts giving you some of their best advice.
All you have to do is ask a question. You'll get 30 or 40 people that can answer it.
I got phenomenal advice as well as lots of offers of free products, free services, free help. You can't pay for some of this stuff, and that's what this group will do for you.
I'd like to think that I spend 90% of my time doing the most important thing, which is probably fun.
My wonderful, fun-loving little group, we tore up the dance club in a way that I know is recorded on camera and I fear will reach the internet at some point in my life.
We decided to create an atmosphere where it's 30% work, 70% play.
I mean, could you imagine partying and going on a cruise with 400 or 500 of your closest friends?
You get to meet people maybe in the JV Jacuzzi or Pizza and Profits at night.
Let me tell you about Pizza and Profits. It's a strange phenomenon.
You go up to the pizza place, which is 24 hours.
And that starts at midnight.
Making new connections.
Launching products.
Deals are cut.
Joint ventures.
And just keeps going and going and going and going and going.
Some of the people go until you smell bacon.
What do you do in your business? Here's what I do in my business. You want a pepperoni pizza? Here's a cheese pizza.
I think that the way that they were able to break the ice for all the entrepreneurs there is really just setting the tone of we're here to learn, we're here to share, you're here with your peers, and they really set the right framing for the entire week.
And you know what? You don't have to be an internet marketer to be on this cruise. We've got healers, we've got doctors, we've got chiropractors, we've got amazing people doing all kinds of things.
Like I said, I've made a lot of connections with people, top people that I would never have access to if I was not on this cruise. We had a white hot party costume, everybody's having fun.
So just from the magic of cruising on the Caribbean Ocean in January on a sparkly ship that has a lot of cool things, entertainment. So you're in a relaxed atmosphere where things happen organically.
It's about having fun. It's about making friends, enjoying yourself. And the business comes.
And the connections just happen.
To me, the important thing is how can we connect and how can we help each other, not how can we make money. Any long-term relationship can't be rushed into, and a period of getting to know each other has to occur. Because once you remove yourself from that context of this conversation is supposed to lead me to monetary gain, it'll lead you to a much deeper gain, which is the gain of connection to another person.
And everybody's just out to help you. And I've never been in anything like that before.
And when you leave, it's not a business relationship, it's a pal, it's a friend. And that's what the Maltese Cruise is about. It's about friendship.
I'm gonna use a little cruise metaphor, but I believe that a rising tide raises all ships. And that when people are brought together under a commonality to achieve greater things together, they can.
So I'm very proud of this video. And I see the questions, I will answer them, but I want to tell you the story of this video. Two young men, Jubril and Dan Usher, come on the cruise a few years ago with all this video gear and equipment. They own a small video production company, and they want to document what's going on this cruise that they had no idea what it would do for them or their business, but they wanted to make a video. They didn't ask for permission. You know, it's better to ask for forgiveness than permission. So I see them running around the ship making this video, and then they asked me to say a few words, and I had no idea what they were up to. I had no idea that they would spend 3 months in post-production. 90% of it wound up on the cutting room floor, and what was left was the 4 minutes that you saw. These are not actors. They're our friends that go on the marketer's cruise every year. And so they make this video, and it's a super-duper video. Even Carnival was impressed with it. And they say, hey, Lou, if you like the video, will you use it, and would you kind of tell people who we are? And they showed me the video, and I love the video. And I said, wow, this is fantastic. This will be our number one marketing piece for the cruise. How much do we owe you for all this work that you did on the cruise when you were supposed to be on vacation? And then in post-production afterwards, they said, well, we normally charge for something like this about $10,000. And I said, oh, I think it's worth every penny. And they said, Lou, you don't owe us a cent. And I said, why would you do this for free? Put all this work into this. They said, just from the people that we met on the cruise that have businesses that need video production work, we've already made $150,000 thanks to you. So we're not going to take the 10 grand from you. We want this to be our gift to you. Just promote us to anyone you know that needs quality professional video. See, right there, was that a little bit of a joint venture? Was it a little bit of affiliate marketing? What was that? From coming on the cruise, we helped them make six figures. I didn't know about it. They gifted me this video. Someone asked in the chat about affiliate marketing. Where is that question? Roger, help me get back to that question.
Igni says, what do you think about leveraging other people's lists for affiliate marketing? I've known it to be the proper convention to build your own from scratch.
The proper convention to build your own. Well, actually, my first cruise was an affiliate marketing cruise. If you think about it, I don't own the cruise line or the ships. I'm an affiliate of cruise.com. I'm an affiliate of Carnival Cruise Lines. And my entire business, which is a seven-figure business at this point, is kind of affiliate marketing, isn't it? But in terms of getting your feet wet, yes, affiliate marketing is the way a lot of people start, by endorsing a product or service that they use and they believe in. And yes, you can use other people's lists. When you teach and train on that product or service that you're an affiliate of, and you're building your list. So yes, certainly there's a multitude of people on the marketing cruise that can help you with that. Again, we have hundreds from around the world. And a lot of people get started with affiliate marketing before they have their own product or service. I still get some checks from years ago. From the first thing that I did in 2003, there was Armin Morin's audio generator, instant video generator, and something called Instant Teleseminar. Instant Teleseminar is still around, and I promoted it. And, you know, whatever it was, $97 a month, you get 30%. I still, to this day, get checks. There's another service that I promoted. I don't know. I get a couple hundred dollars a month from out of nowhere from things I did years ago, just for fun, as affiliate marketing. $200-$300, not a lot of money, but, and that's without even trying. Some people make full-time livings from internet marketing, six figures and beyond, by being super affiliates. You'll meet some super affiliates on the Marketers Cruise. So if you don't have a pro, now I've got books and training programs in the travel industry and home study courses different cruise events that I put on around the world for different leaders. And that has all happened as a natural progression of building your business. But at the very beginning, if I had nothing, I would start with affiliate marketing. So I agree that's a great thing. Let's move forward, get out of the video, go to the next slide. So if this cruise isn't until November, why are we talking about this now? 385 of our friends have already reserved for next cruise, most before even getting off the ship in January of 2020. We were supposed to be doing this cruise this past January, but a little thing called COVID pushed us down, because ships have not been sailing until about a week or two ago. All of the Grand Ocean Suites are sold out. Balcony staterooms are next to go. The ship sells out each year, months in advance. And right now, as we're recording this and doing this live, fewer than 28 cabins are left. I do events, high level events for companies that do charge $5,000, $8,000, $10,000 and above just to be in the room at our cruise ship special events. But we decided, my partner Mike Fulsame and I decided many years ago, as our give back to the marketing community that's done so much for us, to keep this at our cost. very close to our cost, $1,498 per person, not per day, but for the entire 8-day marketer's cruise experience. That's just about what it would cost you to just go on a vacation anyway on a cruise ship with Joe the plumber from Idaho and not have all the things that we're including. So easily, this should be marked up by 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, but we've kept this affordable. The gentleman that asked, how do I get into any of this with zero funds? Well, you need some, but you can't run a business without some money. It does not need to be $50,000 or $100,000. It doesn't even need to be $10,000. Many of us have started on a shoestring and built things using leverage and relationships. So right now we're offering an invitation to join the marketer's cruise with just a $250 per person deposit times two, because it's double occupancy, and pay the balance at the end of July.
Hi, my name is Robert Allen, and I'm here at the Marketer's Cruise. We're having an absolute wonderful time. This is my friend, Captain Lou. It's actually not him, but it kind of looks like him. This is amazing. I came here not as a seminar promoter, but as a student. I wanted to learn what was going on the internet. And I can't believe the things I've been learning here. It's absolutely amazing. Matter of fact, Captain Lou just 5 minutes ago told me how I could get my own live streaming television show. And it blew my mind. And it's things that these guys, look at them here. We're here at this event. We're doing some networking. Look at them all. They're literally sharing ideas with each other right now. They're filling out, they're passing around cards. I'm telling you, if you learn just one idea at an event like this, it would change your life. It's changed my life. And I'm so glad that I came. It was worth every penny I spent to be here. And I think you should come the next cruise. It's going to be fantastic. Just one contact, one idea, one strategy can change your life forever. Don't miss it.
Now, Roger, you certainly know of Robert Allen, No Money Down, big real estate guru in the 80s, best-selling New York Times best-selling author.
I know of him, don't know him personally, but look forward to meeting him.
From having him as a guest on the Marketer's Cruise, he paid for the, everyone has to buy their cabin, but by becoming friends with him, I actually got to share the stage with him in London, and that made that about a year or two later, which officially made me an international speaker. I guess if I speak in Canada, I'm also an international speaker, right, Roger? So I didn't have to fly all the way to London, did I?
No, you didn't.
So just to not go too much over time here, I'll let you know what the booking of the Marketer's Cruise includes. 8 fun-filled days and nights aboard the Magic, visiting more exotic destinations in 1 week than most people see in a lifetime. You know that's true? Very blessed. Your beautiful balcony ocean view stateroom, up to 8 gourmet meals daily and entertainment nightly, all of our mastermind sessions, private parties, and round robin networking dinners. That's where the action happens. And all port charges, taxes, and government fees are included. So there's no little up charges and nickel and diming that I hate when they slide it into the bill afterwards. Don't you hate booking a trip or ordering something, and then you get 18 different extra charges. The price is in U.S. dollars. That is true. It is in U.S. dollars. And here's, guys, stay with me. Guys and gals, I want to show you how to 10x your ROI on the cost of joining us by day 3 while on holiday. Because people say, oh, I don't know if I can afford this. And the idea is to be so prepared that you come there and you make it a profit center, not a cost. So it's about 10xing your return on your investment while being on vacation. So the Marketer's Cruise includes stage time for every one of our guests. This is one of our other group leaders, Iman Agay, that Roger, I'm sure you know. On day 1, you get up on stage and you describe who you are, what you do, and what you're looking for. And you're talking to 400 world-class entrepreneurs from around the world. So you don't have to chase them down. They will look for you. And on a cruise ship, you won't be too hard. You can't hide. You know, water all around. You're on a cruise ship. The Marketer's Cruise also includes a full page about you in our printed directory. So what happens is, when you get up on stage and do your elevator speech, your 30-second audio logo, You say, I'm on page 72 to learn more about me. And people turn to your page, and if they feel a connection, a synergy, like the organic grocer that just chatted in the chat box, and they want to come to you like that woman in 2003 came to me with a JV idea or proposal, they've got the whole week to do so. This is where the magic happens. I call it pull marketing, not push. You're not pushing yourself on anyone. You're just warmly sharing the blessings that you have to offer to create a win-win in business. It's taken me a while to figure this out. So these are sage words of wisdom on how to get more business to come to you than you ever imagined. Roger, you will experience this yourself in just a few short months. We also have a private Facebook group so you can meet your shipmates before we set sail. And we're talking about more than 400. So you can do anything, but you can't do everything. So you want to be selective in the synergies that you're looking for and the goals that you want to achieve. The Marketers Cruise also includes thousands of dollars in valuable gifts, trainings, software, and more from your colleagues and future joint venture partners. So one thing we tell everyone from day one is check your ego at the door, and you're not here to sell your widget to someone in the hall or on the way to the pool. You want to gift your whatever product it is to people that have lists, that have power, that have presence in the marketplace, that could team with you for greater distribution. So you want to gift your products, your trainings, yourself. So we get people to contribute thousands and thousands of dollars of software and live event tickets and training programs, because they're hoping to find partners that will promote them even higher. You're looking for strategic distribution partners, not customers on the Marketers Cruise. If all of this seems kind of high level and over some heads, we even have a book that's a primer that will teach and train you on how to be prepared to get that ROI once you're on board and not be the deer in the headlights that I was when I came to the big seminar in Dallas in 2003. And that's my newest book, Just Add Marketers, How to Plug In, Partner and Profit While Playing at Sea with the World's Top Marketers. It takes you page by page, step by step, on how to be properly prepared so that you can make the most out of your experience. So how do we know cruises will be safe to sail again by 4 months from now? Well, new health and hygiene protocols are already not just planned, but in action as ships have started to sail 2 weeks ago. Strict sanitization, COVID testing. Most people are, of course, at this point, vaccinated. As Roger alluded to earlier, they just announced this past week that Canadian citizens that are fully vaccinated, both shots plus the 2 weeks, can now come and go without having to be quarantined or to have to worry. So our international travel is opening up. We're really happy about that. And we aren't the first to go. We have 12 sailings on our specific ship, the Magic, between now and November 6th, where thousands of people will be setting sail and returning in good health and good cheer. No outbreaks, no COVID. We don't want, it should actually be safer than a trip to your local supermarket. That's the goal of the cruise industry. Safer than a trip to your local supermarket, because they're creating a bubble of cleanliness, safety, and good hygiene. And they're being really careful that there are no outbreaks and no health crises as we move into a post-COVID world and back to hopefully the old normal. Now, just to rest your mind, if travel concerns persisted 4 months from now and the ship, for some reason, something happened, you know, obviously your investment would be protected. We would reschedule for 2022. But bite your tongue, that's not happening. The world is opening up again. Thank God, knock on wood, so we can get out and maybe hug each other again real soon. The deposits and all payments are, of course, transferable if worst case scenario, but we're thinking right now 98% that everything is a go and good to go, and we can't wait to welcome everyone aboard. So we're asking if you'd like to join us, go ahead and put in your deposit of $250 per person. The balance end of June has been extended to end of July because we were waiting for that Canadian announcement on travel restrictions. So that's very, very important. Somebody just wrote, I don't own my own ship. I'm partnering with Carnival somehow to run my events. What exactly do I do that? I can't explain further. Okay, so basically, right, that's a seminar in itself on how I partner with Carnival to produce events like this. So I'm not reliant just on the paltry commission you get from the cruise ship. We're allowed in doing a special event at sea to mark up the event as a group event with all the meetings and parties and private dinners and 18 hours of business building sessions on board. We're allowed to mark up a small markup. I'll be honest, it's only that's a couple hundred dollars, but with hundreds of people, that adds up real fast. And we're allowed to charge that small markup so that now I'm not only making the affiliate commission as an agency of Carnival, but I'm also making the event producers profit, which again, in this event is not a lot, but if you've got 400 or 500 people, just do the math. It's, you know, it's not, if you do a few events like this a year and one brings in 100,000, another one brings in 50,000, and another one brings in 150,000, that adds up real quickly. It's really amazing how once you reach a critical mass of people around the world that want what you have, how you can go from six figures to mid six figures and above and create a real business just out of really what I'm doing here is just affiliate marketing, right? I'm affiliated with Carnival and cruise.com, and we're enhancing things by creating a special event on a cruise ship as a group event. So if the screen says balance by the end of June, it's June is over. So it's sorry about that typo. I should have updated that. The balance will be due at the end of July. Yes, children are welcome and they will have a blast. They have the water slides. Oh my goodness. They have Camp Carnival. And Camp Carnival has scavenger hunts and pizza parties and preteen disco and computer learning and everything that I didn't have as a child that you can have, you know, on a cruise. Absolutely something. And what's interesting, yeah, I'm going to hit the admit button on that. We have somebody coming in at the very end. So welcome, late. Better late than never. Only $599 USD to add a third or fourth person to your cabin, regardless of age. So if you have a 17-year-old, that's fine. They're welcome. They'll have a blast. And guess what? Your spouse and your kids are warmly welcome to join us in the mastermind meetings if they have an entrepreneurial bent, because I wish I had that when I was a kid to learn. How many of you feel that if you knew what you know now, back then, what you could have done with the time? We just didn't know what we didn't know, right? So we want people to come and participate if they're so inclined. If not, go sit in the hot tub, get a massage, we'll make your donation at the casino on board. That's fine as well. Everything's optional. The only thing required is that you guys have fun. And that's, we've always made it about the fun. So the question is, will you be having breakfast on your balcony overlooking the ocean on that week in November, or will Roger and I be sending you a postcard from paradise? That's up to you.
This is John Cornetta from formidablemarketers.com. I just want to let you know that the Marketers Cruise has been crazy. You know, I just entered internet marketing, as most of you know, in 2010. And in late 2010, I saw the Marketers Cruise and said, I want to be on that boat, you know, that ship. And this year made it happen. And Captain's driving me crazy, but no, it was great, great trip. Got to meet wonderful people. And you know what? Not only this, I did $10,000 in sales on the boat in coaching programs. Okay, they probably go to $20,000 tonight. So not only did I pay for this trip, I profited. I was looking for a tax write-off. I had a tax gain. What do you know, huh? So, you know, get out here. It's ridiculous. They can't run from you, okay? If you want to make a JV deal, there's nowhere to go. It's ocean on both sides of the boat, front and back. Get out here next year. I want to see you here, okay?
Oh, great. I have a testimonial for you. You don't know this yet. You guys don't know this yet. But this is our fourth This is our fifth cruise. On our third cruise, I met a client that is currently paying me $15,000 to $30,000 a month and has been paying me that for the last year and a half straight. So by coming here, I've already made, what is that, like 200 grand? Yeah, I probably made over $200,000 just from one contact here on the cruise. So thank you very much, Lou. Thank you, Mike. Thank you, Donna, for putting this amazing cruise together. 200 grand plus.
Hi, I'm Joel Terrian from kiosk.ws, and I'm here on Mike Vilsame's MarketerCruise.com. I got to tell you, that is the best thing that I've ever done for my business. You can only connect with so many relationships and so many people in cyberspace, whether it's through email, virtual conference rooms, whatever. If you want, marketing is, and joint venturing with people belly to belly is where it's truly at. Yes, you can develop a lot of relationships online, but there's nothing like meeting face to face with other like-minded people. The masterminding is absolutely phenomenal. The joint ventures that are created are nothing less than phenomenal as well. I got to tell you that I'm a repeat customer of Marketing Cruising and have built my business an additional $550,000 in 1 year alone. So if you're considering the cost to benefit ratio, you need
to be. You can truly classify me as a beginner. I'm a real estate guy. I've made my money in real estate, but I got into internet marketing simply because the draw of the positivity of the people involved. Like, you know, these people have a like mindset. I brainstormed with these really gurus here on the cruise. We had breakout lunches. I was able to pick their brain and turn a website that was making me $0 into $1 million a year profit center for myself. So whether you're an experienced internet marketer or a beginner, if you're not on the Marketer's Cruise, you are missing out.
America.biz, and this is the best cruise ever, because where else can you mastermind in your swimsuit with thousands of other internet marketers? I love it. Captain Lou is the best. You should definitely come next year.
Hi, it's Kasia Naleta from international.gov.kb.com. We are in Aruba. It's just beautiful, and basically that's our mastermind and that's our lifestyle, and I wish everyone to be here, and I really strongly encourage you to come here next year with all of us. Thanks so much.
Now I just want to say this last testimonial of these two young ladies, they didn't make $1 million as a result of the Marketer's Cruise or hundreds of thousands of dollars in business growth, but I had to leave that in there for the benefit of you gentlemen. What do you think? I leave that in. I mean, for the I think this was, you know, we need a mix of everything, don't we? So so basically, somebody's writing from project coordinator. Who's the project coordinator? Is that your project coordinator, Roger?
I think so.
Just figuring out how to use this. Lucky I found the chat. Question: how can I get email to you guys? Captain Lou and Roger. Well, for me, it's marketerscruise@gmail.com. So you could certainly write me, type in here, marketerscruise@gmail.com with any questions. Sure. So as we say, it's a vacation integrated with profit. And you're seeing people in different niches that come on the cruise and create joint ventures, leverage each other's lists, launch all new products and partnerships. There's so many different ways to skin the internet cat. Whenever I see these videos, I'm so touched by the creativity of what people have done. This, the one guy that you saw in the first video, John Cornetta, came on board. He was already a great marketer and he had coaching programs. So he was able to get coaching clients that paid him for his coaching. But his goal was to meet my partner, Mike Vilsame, who is a multi-million dollar online marketer and software developer who's built several companies over the last decade or two. And John wanted to just meet with him, break bread, have dinner, whatever. And now years later, they're partners on a company called Groove Digital. You guys can check that out and you get a free account of the software, groove.cm. which does everything that you need to run your business online. And Groove is a business that started about a year and a half ago and has gone from zero to $29 million in sales online in this past year, he's got some $5,000 suite on the cruise now, as does Mike, as many, many of the people do. The interesting thing is he came as a guest on the cruise, made money by Wednesday, a few years later, was partners in what's going to be probably a $150 million company. He's partners with Mike Fulsang. Now, I'm partners with Mike on the cruise, but not in the $100 million company. You never know where life is going to take you. I toss these numbers around because I never felt that I could be one of those people, that I could order off of the right side of the menu instead of the left side of the menu. I got to get that early bird special. I never thought that I deserved the success that God has granted me when I took that leap of faith and showed up in 2003 in that story that I told you and learned how to leverage other people's lists, which happens just so naturally and organically in the right atmosphere. Let me finish with, folks, you've come this far. You got up on a Saturday morning. Right now on the East Coast, it's a Saturday afternoon. And I really appreciate you attending our little soiree here with Roger. Why not go all the way? So we want to see you in this picture, maybe even be bold enough to be the only one in the hot tub when we're taking the group photo. Thank you, Dustin. And we warmly invite you. We're not selling you, because if this is not for you, then fine. You know, but we warmly invite you to join us in Roger's VIP inner circle on board. And there's Captain Roger there on the front of the boat. Do you like the drawing we made of you, Roger?
I certainly do. It's the pink I'm particularly fond of.
I'm glad. So yes, that's actually Captain Zilla. That was somebody drew for me. I thought I'd throw that in there because he's cute. But that can be Captain Roger as well. I'm willing to share the love and the spotlight. So folks, don't miss the boat. Let's not be too stiff. Passing in the night. What we would like you to do right now is, let me go back, claim one of the few remaining cabins. If you feel moved to join us, look, it's been a long year and a half of the dreaded COVID. I, for one, look forward to wearing my free hugs t-shirt that's also hot pink. But I'm straight, remember, I'm straight. But anyway, I, for one, look forward to seeing everybody in person. These things are great, Zoom meetups. Thank you, Roger, for facilitating this and many other business building things that you do. I caught your presentation, love what you do with the TEDx talks. And we want you in person with the world's top marketers, sharing your dreams and goals and ideas and businesses so that other people can help you take your business to the next level. And you can be a blessing in their lives as well. A rising tide lifts all boats. If you'd like to join us, you go to marketerscruise.com or to the affiliate link. That's Roger's affiliate link that he put into the chat room. Now, can I take 2 extra minutes now that I've already gone over by 20, Roger?
May as well.
That's an emphatic endorsement. I'm going to go over to marketerscruise.com because there's something I want to show you that's very, very important. I'm going to open up a new tab and I'm going to type in marketerscruise.com. We're going to go over to the main site and we're going to click on book now right there. And you get to the enrollment form and you see, sold out. Well, there's a room that's available and there's another room that's available. Most of the rooms are sold out, but a couple of nice rooms still available right there. And what you want to do when you're booking the cruise is, I call your attention, let me actually pinch the screen to make it larger, to this section that says, we were invited by, and it's got in alphabetical order, all of our affiliate partners and leaders that are inviting their tribes, people they know that deserve to go. And in this list, I certainly hope that there is a Roger Killen. Otherwise, I will have egg on my face.
It's higher up.
Are you there?
Yeah, but higher up.
Higher up. It's supposed to be in alphabetical order. You've seen it?
I saw it whenever you opened the page.
When I opened the page, you saw it because your name has got to be there.
Yeah, but it's not in alphabetical order.
We'll have to fix that. Because imagine having to search through hundreds of names here. Well, we got to find Roger. And EFG, HI, J, K. What happened to Roger? Well, as soon as we're off of this Zoom, I will go in and fix this and put you in bold, all caps, Roger, so that they can find you. And because we want to know that Roger invited you. I don't know where Roger is, but we'll put you in the right order in about 5 minutes. And when you go there, click on that or type into the comments. Type into the comments, invited by Roger Killen. But we're going to get that fixed. And that's what we want to know. So somebody says we should start, be able to start typing ROG and it will come in. Let's try that. Hold on. So if I just type ROG, no, that's Robert Murray. Something's wrong. Okay, it was there before, Roger, I swear. So we'll get that fixed because that also tracks your affiliate link. Affiliate marketing is supposed to be easy. Anyway, folks, that's the story and I'm sticking to it. Thank you so much for hanging in there with me, listening to my story. I want to inspire you to achieve your best life ever with the rest of your life. The clock is ticking. Let's make the most of our businesses and our lives by living that lap type lifestyle that I espouse with the marketers. Thank you, Roger.
Thank you, Lou. Thank you for sharing this novel approach to forming JV partnerships. I can't think of anything more enjoyable.
Ditto, same here. And thank you, everybody. Have a great rest of the weekend.